guys, welcome back to another video today. Ow. And today I'm going to be doing a Minecraft tutorial video. I've never done one before. So today's video is going to be about how to make an XP farm or mob grinder. So let's get into it. But before we start today's video, let's try to reach, let's say, let's try to reach 5 likes today, and I'm sorry if there's going to be any interruptions. I'll be right back, and I just wanted to say sorry if there's any interruptions, but let's get into today's video. So, let's say you were walking around the world and stumbled across a mob spawner. Boom. You find one, kill all the mobs in it. Now, I'm going to get a sword just so I don't accidentally break anything. Whoops. I'll put that on. Let's say you killed everything. So yeah, you took out all the loot, which is great. We'll break this stuff. Boom, you're done. And then you're like, I don't care anymore. I've taken everything, I'm gone. But no, that's not what you're meant to do. What you're meant to do is not to break this. What you're meant to do is, first, let's start off by making a 9x9 room. So this would be the fifth thing. So one, two, three, four, and then five, like that. And then you do the same thing for the other side. So one, two, three, four, five. And then you do it again. One, two, three. Oh my gosh, there's so many distractions, guys. I'll be right back. So now I have outlined what the 9x9 room would look like. So now you would just break everything like this. It's okay if the torches are broken. Whoops, I'll fix that. Then. So, you do this in creative. I'm doing it in this creative because it'll be faster. But this can you can also do this in survival though. Let me fix that and whatever. And just like that. Oh, come on. Well, that doesn't really matter because we're gonna deal with that in a second. And sometimes you may find ores. Now this is a surface spawner, or like close to surface spawner. This will also work for underground spawners too, so don't worry too much about that. And then, once you have a 9x9 room, you could even count to check. I'm gonna place down a few torches though, so like nothing starts to spawn. And then, boom. You can build a wall, but you don't have to right now. So then, boom, you count, see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And then, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Boom, that's a 9x9 room. The next thing you need to do is make sure it's a 4-tall ceiling. And this is already 4 tall, so we're good. And then the next thing you do is then you dig down by 2 blocks, like over here. So 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, and so on. So let me just finish this, and then we can continue on with the video. So like everything I'm talking about and doing is required, so if you mess up something, something bad could go on. So, yeah. Oh my goodness! Dug down by 2. Then you can, like back here, you can dig out 1 row like this. And then this will be for, like, later on, where the skeletons will float in. So then, when after you do that, you dig in two from the wall. Make sure it's directly, like, parallel to this. So then you dig out these two. Then you go into. Okay. And then... So, basically... Now you, what you're supposed to do is you dig up, so you need like 9 signs. Let me, it's, I don't know where they are. I think they're over here. So yeah. And then water bucket, like this. Then it's okay if you run into the surface like I will, because I've done this before. So basically what you do is, oh yeah, and also to make sure you did this right, you can place a water bucket here and a water bucket here, and then it should meet in the middle and go that way. And then, basically, when the skeleton's trying to get it, they won't be able to go anywhere. And then, so, let me walk that up. You don't have to do that part yet. And then, what you do is you, well, let's start by putting a sign here, you don't have to do anything. And then you place water, and you do this 9 times. You need 9 signs, and I guess 9 buckets of water. So after that, you place, so that's sign number 2, and then water, sign number 3, and then water. Sign number 4, then water. Sign number 5, and then water. So then when I ran into this issue in my survival world, I forgot how many I placed, I'm gonna have to count. That's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Then what I just did was this, and sign number 6, and then water, and then sign number 7, and then you add some water. Sign number 8, and then water. And then sign number 9. And then you put down the last water bucket. For now, I'm going to do this. So then, let me read my book where I wrote this down. Go forward by 2 floors. Wait, which way is it? So what I did was, I went forward this way, so that's what I'm going to do. And then, so I go forward that way. So, you go 2 floors back. The 2 water flows. I'll show you what I mean. Then that's 2 flows. And then what I do again now is another 2 flows of water. So what you do is you place a second bucket of water over here and do the same thing. Now if this is an underground mob spawner, then you won't have to worry about this. because you want me to go above ground. And then once you've gone two floors, gonna do this. No, you don't need this. Then you can cover all of this. Make sure it's at least two. So like, you can stand here and see. And then you can do this. So basically, you go here, then they flow on to the next one, which is right here.
Okay.
And then you move on. So I'm gonna go in real quick and make sure it works so that the skeleton spawns. I'm gonna put water over here. We're not there yet. Then they go here. The water will be forcing them to swim up. And they go up. And after they go up. Oh wait, no, they face. Wait, did I block it? Oh no, I didn't. And they keep going this way. And then the water. And then what you have to do now is go down by, dig down 21 blocks. So that's one. And here's where my problem starts. Let me connect this real quick. And then you can do this if you don't. If you can do this if yours is an above ground spawner. If this is a, if you have a on a below ground spawner, then you can just dig down 21 blocks. Just be careful though. So let me actually see this. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. I'm gonna count again now. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, and then 21. So then what you can do is just fill this up like I'm going to right now. So that they don't try to walk out or anything. Which they wouldn't be able to because they'd be falling. Then after you have that done, so then once you're down 21 blocks, and then this is where they would die, so gonna make a little base. Let me get some cobblestone just so you can see the difference. Then you can get a slab where they're gonna land. I'll use this. And then there you can build yourself like a mini base after I get out of here. So have to be too big. So like that's where the mobs are gonna come. I'm gonna get a night vision potion so you guys can see. But then you would place down torches. So basically this is where you would be. And then this would be like this, all around it. And then you can make yourself a mini base. And then boom. You can add some chests or whatever you want to do. So this is my base over here. And make sure, you can also make sure that you can get to your base. So like you dig up and then get a ladder. So yeah, this is my base. And let's say I get at it by here. Then I go up, and then boom, right here, at the spawner. So then the next thing you want to do is, you can actually start to cover this up, but make sure you leave room so you can put down a door. Just so you can like see that they're spawning and stuff. But before we finish that, this is the part where you start to place down water up here. So then what you do now is make sure you do this all the way across. And make sure it's like completely like this. And then you can place your water at the sides here. And it should work. Then they go. And they come here. Well, actually, before we do this, let me make sure this works for me. Okay. That's good. Oh, well. Whatever. So then they'd flow. For now, what you have to do is remove all your torches. It's still gonna look bright for me because, I have a night vision potion. So let me break all of this. I wish I didn't place so many. So then now, let me destroy all of that. And then you want to make sure you build a wall now. So then now, you build your wall, so you can get out, and then break the rest of your torches, and then you break the final one, and then boom, you quickly get out, and then you get a door, so make sure you make a door ahead of time, and then boom, you see them going in. Oh wow. He had to be the one guy to spawn up there. You don't have to worry about them too much. You could like bow them down if you wanted to. Or just leave them there. So then you go down to your base right here where they come. And then boom! You kill them. To get XP. And just to show you some just to show you evidence, I'm gonna go in survival and show you that you can get XP. Wait for them to come. Yeah. I don't know, I have that many levels, but you will not get 19 levels from this, like, right away. But yeah, you slowly start to gain experience. Then you can also, like, dig this up by, oh wait, let me go back into creative. But what you can do then, like, dig this up by one, so it's not too cramped. And make sure you leave, like, leave the thing like this. So they don't walk out. And then you have your XP farm. And then you just do this. And then you get XP. So that's the end of today's tutorial. And I hope you guys should enjoy today's video, and see you guys next time. Bye!